Dear students, in this video I am going to discuss about the expression for Young's modulus of a single cantilever. So as we know, a cantilever is a beam which is fixed at one point and the other end is free. So a load is added on the other side, W, and see, we have the beam which is fixed at the point M, and so the load is added at the point N. And as we add load, see, the beam is going to bend this way. And let us consider a point P on the beam which is at a distance x from the fixed end M. So the length of the beam is L meters, and the distance from this point P to the loaded end, that's L minus x. So a load W is acting at the point N, and now we are going to find out what's the expression for the Young's modulus of a single cantilever. So to find the Young's modulus, see, we have to find what's the bending moment for this particular beam. So the bending moment, see, that is a reaction induced in a structural element when an external force is applied to the element causing it to bend. So that's called as a bending moment. So that's given by force into the perpendicular distance. So in this case, the force, that is the weight W, so into the perpendicular distance, so into, see, the distance from here, that is no L minus X. So W into L minus X. And we have already derived an expression for the bending moment of a beam. So that is bending moment. So that's given by, so in the previous video, we have found what's the expression for the bending moment. So that's given by Y by R into IG, where Y is Young's modulus. And R is a radius of the bent beam, and IG is a geometrical moment of inertia. So now just equate these two relations. So we have Y by R into IG, so that's equal to W into L minus X. Okay, so from this we can write 1 by R, so that's equal to W divided by Y into IG into L minus X. So let this be equation number 1. So here, see, we have R, that is a radius of the circle of the bent beam that, you know, that forms a part. And mathematically, we have an expression for this radius R, which is given by 1 by R, so that's equal to d square y by dx square approximately. So it has got some additional terms. So approximately, it is taken as 1 by R is equal to d square y by dx square. So mathematically, so this is the equation number 2. So we have two equations, 1 and 2, whose LHS are same. So just equate. So d square y by dx square, so that's equal to W divided by y into IG into L minus X. Yes, so now let us find out what's the expression for y from this particular relation. So if you look at this diagram, see, at the point N, so as we add the load, see, there is a depression going to take place, and this depression which happens at the point N, so that is taken as Y naught. And once the beam is bent, see, the position of P is going to shift to P dash. So whatever depression taking place here is denoted by Y, and at the point N, that is denoted by Y naught. Okay, so we are going to find what's the expression for y from this second order differential equation. So this relation so can be written as d by dx of dy by dx. So that's equal to w divided by y into ig into l minus x, right? So now integrating this, so we can write d of dy by dx, okay, so that's equal to, so I just took this dx towards the right hand side, so d of dy by dx, that's equal to w divided by y into ig into l, so just multiply this dx, l dx minus x dx. So the if you integrate this on either side, so you will get dy by dx, so that's equal to w divided by y into ig within the brackets l dx integral, that is lx minus x dx integral is x square divided by 2 plus c1, that is constant of integration. So let this be equation number 3. Okay. So we got dy by dx, that's equal to w divided by y into ig into lx minus x square by 2 plus c1. So that's a constant of integration. So now we have to find what's the value of the constant c1. So we'll consider the condition, that is when x equal to 0. So in this diagram, see when x equal to 0, okay, so that is when x equal to 0, that indicates this is x, right? So x is 0, that means at this particular point, so that refers to the now at this particular point, what happens to dy by dx, because on the left hand side we have dy by dx. So when x equal to 0, what's the value of dy by dx? What is dy by dx? See, that is dy by dx is the slope of the tangent drawn to the bent beam at a distance x from the fixed end. Okay, now when x equal to 0, so dy by dx is also equal to 0. So at x equal to 0, dy by dx equal to 0, so that indicates that in this particular relation c1 is also equal to 0. So at x equal to 0, dy by dx, that's equal to 0, that implies c1, that's equal to 0. So that means we have, therefore we have dy by dx, so that should be equal to w divided by y into ig into lx minus x square divided by 2, right? So because c1 is equal to 0. Now what is now we have to integrate this further. So that is, I just rearrange the terms, dy, so that's equal to w divided by y into ig into, so dx just cross multiply, lx dx minus x square by 2 dx. Okay, so integrate this, so integrating we will get y, so that's equal to w by yg, say constant, so into integral of lx dx, that is l x square divided by 2, okay, minus x square by 2, so x square, the integral is x cube by 3, so already 2 is there, so 2 into 3, that's equal to 6, plus c2, so again we get a constant. Okay, so we need to find what's the value of the constant c2. So now if you look at this relation, okay, so at x equal to 0, what's the value of y, right? So at x equal to zero. So at this particular point, so there is no depression taking place. So that's why y that's equal to zero. So x equal to zero, y equal to zero. So that implies, so at x equal to zero, y equal to zero. So that indicates that c2, so that's equal to zero, because x equal to zero, y is also equal to zero, c2 equal to zero. So therefore y, so that's equal to w divided by y into ig into lx square by 2 minus x cube by 6. So this is the expression for the depression taking place y at a distance x. Okay, now if x equal to l, that is at the loaded end, so if you look at this diagram, see at the loaded end, so that is if x equal to l, so this is l, so if x equal to l, so what is y? Y is equal to y naught, that's a depression taking place at this particular point, that is y naught. So if I substitute the values, so at the loaded end, that is at x equal to l, y is equal to y naught. So in this particular case, see y naught is given by w by yig into, so at the place of l, x, l you write, so we have l into x square here, so x equal to l, right? So l into, at the place of x you write l, so this becomes l cube divided by 2 minus l cube by 6. So if you simplify further, this will be w divided by yig into, so this is, take the LCM, so 6, 2, 3 times, so it's 3L cube minus L cube, so which will give you Y naught, so that's equal to W by YIG into, so this is 6 here, 2L cube, okay, 2 ones, so here it is 3 times, so this is equal to W L cube divided by 3y into ig. So this is the expression for the depression taking place, so at the loaded end, so y naught is equal to wl cube by 3y into ig. And from this we can write the Young's modulus y, so that's equal to w l cube divided by 3 into y naught into ig. Okay, so 3 y naught into ig. So that is the expression for the Young's modulus. Now see, for a rectangular slab, we know that ig, that's equal to bd cube divided by 12. So for a rectangular slab, so in that case, the Young's modulus is given by W L cube divided by 3 Y naught into B D cube, so divided by 12. So 3 ones, so it's 4 times here. So the final expression for the Young's modulus will be W L cube. So this 4 goes to the numerator. 4 W L cube divided by B D cube into Y naught. So this is the expression for the Young's modulus of a single cantilever. So this is a very, very important topic. So now I am going to discuss about various types of beams. So this is the last portion of this topic, that's about the beams. So we have 4 types of beams. See, the first one is a simple beam. So this is beam which is resting on 2 supports on either side, so that's called as a simple beam, as the name indicates. So we have the supports only at the 2 ends. And the second one is a continuous beam. So here, in addition to the supports at the ends, even in between there is a support, so that's called as a continuous beam. And next one, third one, is a cantilever beam. So as you know, it's a beam which is fixed at one point, other end is free. And we have the fourth one, that's a fixed beam. So the beam which is fixed on either side, so that's called as a fixed beam. and these have got various applications. See, the one of the application is in the fabrication of trolleyways and in elevators and in the construction of bridges. So this is about the types of beams.